at KRC Genk, Belgium. It's halftime and the first team game between Standard Liège and KRC Genk. We look out there, we'll see the substitutes warming up for Standard. And everybody's inside actually probably buying stuff. Kevaughn, how do you feel to be here? So I know that this has been a very long road for you. You know, you started out as a youngster quite prepped when you came to Phoenix. Could you just take us a little bit through all the things and what you learned and the competitions you played and all of that, so you can get an idea of who you really are?
When I first came to Phoenix, I used to attend quite prep school. I thought I was a good player at Quest. I was dominating and those things. And then when I went to Phoenix, Craig took me and showed me a lot of things, because I couldn't drive the ball properly. And he took his time. Sometime after training, he stayed about 2 hours or so with me, and he teach me how to kick the ball properly. And Phoenix is a great club. All of the guys, they are my brothers. Because all of us, we sleep in the same house, cook food together, we run jokes together, we do everything together.
So, what was the after Quest prep, where did you go to school?
I passed my exam and went to Calabar High School.
Yeah. And how was life there at Calabar?
Life was great, because when I was in 7th grade, I was one of the best, if not the best, on the Pepsi team with my fellow Phoenix player, Andre Wilson, and I was a co-captain for that team in 7th grade.
So how many goals did you score that season?
I scored 14 goals in my first year.
While you were in prep school, you had played the Cassava under 13, was that it? Yeah?
Yeah, I played Cassava under 13. I scored 24 goals, leading goal scorer. While some of the guys that played under 13 were like 13, 12, and I was like 10 at that time.
So Kevaughn, how do you feel about your teammates now, the players that you grew up with that are now playing football? Who do you admire the most?
Yeah, I would admire Leon and Kyle Butler, because they just have a difference. When they are playing, it just seems like I am playing with them. It's a joy to watch Kyle and Leon play. Sometimes they take the guys for a joke or something.
Yeah. So how do you feel about life here in Belgium so far? Because now you're in Belgium, right? You were in Austria, Germany. Now you're in Belgium. How do you feel about the training here you've gotten, the life here, the lifestyle, everything?
Yeah, the training has been a great training session, because in the training I have to like pass the ball very hard, and everything that I do, I have to do it very fast. I can't move slow. Yeah, and the lifestyle in Belgium is very good, because in Jamaica you don't have this kind of lifestyle. You go to training in the morning, you go to school, the club provide lunch for you. They make sure that you eat proper lunch, they make sure that you eat, and you go to training in the evening also.
So what is your aspiration about the national team in Jamaica?
Okay, my aspiration for the national team is I really want to be a part of the national team because it's my country. My family lives here. My families are Jamaican. My little sisters are Jamaican. My brothers, everyone of my siblings are Jamaican. So I just want to really be a part of that team. I just want to feel joyful that I'm wearing my Jamaican colors. When I'm playing on the field, I want to look in the stand. I see my family watching. Tears running down my eyes. It would be a great feeling.
Kevaughn, I'm very happy with that, you know. I have always said that I believe that Jamaica can either go to a semi-final or win a World Cup and become a world power in football. How do you really feel about that? Do you believe it the way that I believe it? And why, if you do, why do you think it can happen?
Yeah, I really believe it also, because the Jamaicans, we are talented players. Jamaicans have the fastest human beings on the planet. We are one of the most educated persons in the world. So with that, we could use our speed and our knowledge and use it on the field also.
You've seen what Chippy has been able to do and Kyle has been able to do at even 17 level here and in Austria, right? How do you feel about what they have done? Not about what you have done. I'm not going to ask them about you, but I'm asking you about what they have done.
Yeah, I have
Chippy.
Leon and Kyle, they have done some unnormal things. They have done the abnormal thing because sometimes I'm watching them and Craig said that Kyle put ball right on Leon's foot and Kyle just hit ball and right on Leon's foot and sometimes I'm wondering how he does that. But as you know, it's a Phoenix All-Star. Craig has produced them from there. They were small, so they were taught how to do those things. And they came to these clubs and learned more.
All right, Kevaughn, thank you. On behalf of the Phoenix All-Star Football Academy, whoever watches this, I'd like to thank you for watching it, listening, but more importantly, we want to empower you to let you know that you can believe. You can achieve anything that you want to believe to achieve. And you only have to believe in it. I think seriously, from my perspective, Jamaica can qualify for a World Cup, win a World Cup. You just have to have people at the helm that believe in the program and believe the football. Thank you.